Hi, I'm John, and in this clip I'm going to tell about PyDOM and some of its functionalities. PyDOM is a home automation automotica platform which exists of a server and clients, and is primarily focused on the Raspberry Pi. Well, the server is a Java 8 application and acts as the middleware layer between the clients and devices. It does take the translation between the devices itself and the clients, and any other applied functionalities such as plugins. It can also take decisions based on the rules you define yourself, for example in triggers or macros. The clients are a J5X8 desktop client, which supports two modes, such as a full desktop environment with icons and widgets, or as a small desktop application which can run on the background. The other client is an Android client, which at first only supports phones but will eventually also support tablets and give the same functionality as the desktop version. As said, the server is meant to be a middleware application, so it supports a couple of methods to interact with clients, which are HTTP and HTTPS, WebSockets, secure WebSockets, the raw socket, and a secure raw socket. The communication protocol between the server and the clients is done with JSON, RPC and XML. And these RPC methods are not only to control the devices and plugins attached, but also gives the possibility to manage the server itself. So you are not stuck with clients we provide, you can create your own client or can create your own management interface. We use NetBeans, by the way, to create our projects and to maintain our projects, and we do this for a couple of reasons. It, for example, supports direct deployment to the Raspberry Pi, and so we can see debug output in the NetBeans console. It supports Mercurial DCVS integration because all our projects are hosted on Bitbucket. It has good coding support in the editor, like code hinting, function jumping, nice Lambda support, code highlighting, and some inline help. And also the integration with Jenkins is very important for us because we can instantly view test and build results in NetBeans and act on it. It also supports all the language requirements we have for our platform. For example, Java 8 SA embedded for the server and the server libraries. Java FX 8 we use for the desktop and soon also to become a Raspberry Pi client. And it has support for Android by the help of the Android plugin. The other reason we use NetBeans is we want to create a plugin environment so developers can create their own devices in NetBeans and deploy these directly on the server. So, for example, it will include a graphical editor which creates the necessary XML file to define a device. The server comes with a couple of so-called default devices which will use the XML you create in this editor, so there is no coding needed to create a device to interact with. But if you need it, it will also support the libraries the server uses to communicate with the device drivers, the peripheral software drivers, or the hardware, and it will provide the interfaces for you to create your own plugins, so you can create your own devices and plugins routines. The plugin will also support the possibility to test your device instantly with the server. So when you have created your device XML, you can upload it to the server and you will get a debug output to see if your device expects or handles as you expect it should handle. And next to this debugging functionality, the plugin will also provide a way to create an installation package, so you can create your own plugin, devices and XMLs, and distribute these to other users. So I want to show you now some of the functionality of the server. So this clip shows the current functionality, by the way, so things are still in development and can change in the future. So what you will see here is the server status page. It shows the services running, the availability of specific services, some system information like CPU load, Raspberry Pi temperature, memory used, disk space left, and it will also show graphs of some historic values. So here we have default dashboard. It will be expanded to show not only some favorite devices, but also scenes, macros, and shows you the news and some information we are having. So when we go to control views, you can here see your devices. When you click on a device, you can control a device. You can switch a device on, off, which are actions based on the XML you create. It also here has media, so if there is media attached, you can see here it's playing some media. And this is a good way to show you how WebSockets work, because the web interface is connected with the server with a WebSocket. So when I press a song like this, I want to have played, I press play, and it will update the web interface. It will also show your utility usages, which the server supports, with graphs. It has device management, where you can add, remove, or edit a device. So let's say we do the wall LED strip. It shows the options also created in the XML, which a user can set to control a device. It can give it a name, a category, yes or no favorite, and the location where it is. Custom devices is obsolete. It will be moved to the NetBeans platform, as explained earlier. So when I go to the plugin management, here on media, I can add new media and then select XBMC version 12 and 13, which are included in the server by default. And the utility measurement plugin, with the utility measurements plugin, you can connect a device which measures your usage. So click change device, click the device, and here you can choose the device which is being used. And it supports four different kinds of measurement devices which will measure your wattage usage. R and C are, for example, here in the Netherlands used, and you have here KH. It supports for water and gas. Also included is a messenger service. Messenger service can be used in triggers to send, for example, as you see here, an SMS. When I go to automation, you will here have the triggers and macros, which I will show you in a moment. You can view which users are connected. So we have here a default client, which is, for example, the JavaFX client. And here connected is an Android client. When go to system, you will have the server status, is the page we just have seen. And you can see the attached peripherals. And as you can see here, through USB, we have an Arduino connected. Well, the server can see with what kind of device is connected to USB, because it will use the vendor ID and product ID of the USB device, and it supports hot pluggable devices, so I can just connect and remove, and the server will show you that it's removed or connected. Running here is the GPIO I2C pins, which are enabled by default, and this one is just used to show some server information. To show you, when an Arduino, for example, is connected, the server does not know the baud rate which it has to use. So just click on it, there you select the baud rate, click set and start, and it will try to load automatically the correct driver which is connected to the vendor and product ID. Well, here we have some settings. You can create your own floor levels and rooms. So we have a main floor, which has here a couple of rooms, for example the living room. It supports a visual floor plan, so you can create your own floor plan, which is used in the client, which will you can see about here, where you can attach, you can create a region, which is a room, and you can place a device. You can create your own categories or use one of the standard categories. You can define your user presence. You can use this in triggers. You can set your status like awake, sleeping, unknown, away. You can define your own day parts. For example, you have a a specific Sunday morning, you can just create a specific Sunday morning. And here are some server settings. These will be expanded. These are just a couple of options which are available immediately when changed. Because the server works with time zones and sunrise and sunset, you can define your location here. And this location can be asked can be asked on your browser. So when you press Ask Browser or Device, what you can do, you will get here a pop-up, and you can press guess to guess your location. So it will ask the location of your location at this moment. And what you can do is you can move this map. You can zoom in on the map, and let's say you live over here. Click it. Your latitude, longitude changes. Use this. Close. When you save it, these are the latitude and longitude the server will use. You can enable and disable client authorization. Well, this will be obsoleted because all clients will eventually be authorized. You can enable disable debug logging and a clean way to shut down the server. Well, from the automation, I can show you the macros. A macro is just a set of commands. So when I press add new macro, I can add an item, let's say a device, the main lights, the device actions is switch device, and switch device on. This is determined based on the XML of a device. You can also choose your presence to be changed, another macro to be ran. You can change the part of day, your user status, so if you're away, set it to away. You can choose an action for a media plugin. So here we have a player comment. Let's choose pause, stop, and play. And with triggers, you can, for example, let the server react on input from a media device or an other device, and you can connect this to an execution list. So, for example, when I add a single rule, or let's say an all rule, and when the part of day added part of day is equal to evening, and let's add another one, the media plugin, which is this XBMC 12 instance, player comment is equal to pause. What you then can do is you add an item over here. Let's expand it, this makes it easier. We have a device which is a wall LED strip, and we want another color, and this main light color should be red and color fade. So when I give a name and a description, choose the recurrence. Now we want continuously because it has to occur every time when you press pause. The LED strip will light up red only when the part of day is evening. So with triggers you can create a big list of rules you want to use to create actions to it. Eventually we will also create if then else, so when if part of day is evening or part of day is morning, turn on the lights, and you will have the possibility to create an execution list per status, so per if, else, or. So this is a little bit about PyDown, and the features are still in development and are still expanded. So this is the currently how it works, and I hope to get your interest. Okay, bye bye.